jetzt Anna kommt, ich gehe eine Treppe hoch.
Small, quiet town to the north of Stockholm. But back in the 70s, when the future band members were growing up there, it was far from quiet.
Upplands Väsby was a very musical place. A lot of artists went there to live there or came from there.
It was so much music going on. There was bands everywhere. You could walk down the streets and there was one band over here. You heard them rehearsing and you walk a few yards down the road and there's another band.
There was this community of musicians in this little town of ours. I knew Joey since, because we were playing in the same soccer team. And I knew John. He was like the talk of the town guitar player, even at the age of 12, 13.
I knew John Levin since, you know, before. We just kind of were hanging out sometimes. I went to the same school with Joey. It was kind of cocky.
I think he thought I was quite cocky because I just went up to him in school and said, hey, you think I can borrow your keyboard? It's, you know, no social awareness. And he's like, well, I guess so.
Joey, then 16, needed Gunnar's keyboard to write a song using the new electronic sounds that were coming through at the dawn of the 80s.
I was in that room, my parents' place, down in the basement, checking out, going through the sounds. And it's impossible to know where the melody, why it flew into my head. It took me a while to find out one, the last one. So it's all about trial and error. It's all about trying what sounds good to me and what moves me. So I did this piece, it was 1 minute long that night, and I did a demo of it. And I had it, and I thought, this is interesting. But it was just an idea on the tape.
Joey abandoned that idea and left the tape on the shelf. It just didn't fit with the new hard rock approach he was taking with his new band, Force, which featured John Norum on guitar, John Lennon on bass, and Tony Reno on drums.
So we started to jam and immediately we had a very good chemistry. It was very good, like, good energy. We got along great and we had a lot of laughs together and jammed a lot together and hung out pretty much every day, you know.
From day one, when we started playing, we were totally determined that we were going to be big and famous. The confidence of a 17-year-old.
With world domination the aim, Rolf Magnus Joachim Larsen changed his name to Joey Tempest after singing the Shakespeare play in a school library.
It could be cool to have something, and it became part of the whole thing.
Joey's girlfriend sent this demo into this rock competition, and we didn't know about it. We had no idea.
Force were one of 80 groups chosen to compete in various battles of the bands across Sweden. Soon the competition was thinned, and they came across another local musician, Håkan Haugland, and his band Trilogy.
And he was just stealing the show. It was a three-piece band. He was singing and doing all that. And who's that guy?
That was crazy motherfucker behind the drums and also doing the singing, you know.
Dude, that's a fucking great drummer.
We were kicked in the ass by Force, obviously. I was furious and heartbroken, but at the same time, I had to confess to myself that Force were much better band.
Force reached the final, but before that gig, Joey decided they needed a more distinctive band name.
We were drinking beer, and he said, I got a new name for the band.
So we were all curious, you know, so what's the name of the band?
Hold on a second here, you know. I'm not going to tell you yet. Like, have a few more beers here first. You know?
I was so nervous telling the guys that name.
So the night kept going Europe here, and eventually they told me, John...
Europe? Dead quiet.
And John Levin and I, we just looked at each other, it's like, is this guy on drugs or what?
Really? It's a continent.
Oh man, that is a dreadful name.
Oh my goodness, I was just thinking this did not go well.
Yeah, we had a few more beers, you know, it started to sink in a bit more, and after a while it was like, maybe it's not that bad, this name. Oh, Europe.
A few beers later, we said, one of the best names ever.
It worked. Whether it's good or not, that's up to anybody else.
Amongst the hundreds of thousands watching on TV was a very grumpy Håkan Haugland, who'd now given up his band and was working as a baggage handler at Stockholm Arlanda Airport.
So I was sitting there watching the guys that kicked us out of the competition go there and winning the competition. So I had a hard time being happy for them. I have to say, I was a bit miserable.
The first prize was to record their debut album. You are the children of this time. You are the bread of the vine. You are companions to the end. You got yourselves to defend. Soon after that was released, they were back playing a festival in their hometown of Upplands Väsby.
Avalon, my band, was one of the bands playing.
Avalon were opening for us. I thought they were pretty good.
Avalon's show went without a hitch. And then Europe took to the stage with Joey singing and playing keyboards.
So I was trying to, you know, entertain and play at the same time. And something happened with the keyboard.
And his keyboard kept breaking down.
Just kept going and going and going and going. And he was pushing all his buttons and stuff like that.
And he was so upset about it.
It was complete disaster.
Would Gunnar save the day and lend Joey a keyboard for a second time?
No, no. And not a chance.
The album Wings of Tomorrow soon took flight, establishing their reputation as Scandinavia's best hard rock band. Joey also decided playing the keyboards was getting in the way of being a rock frontman. He remembered Gunnar McKay, the school friend whose keyboard he'd used to write the Final Countdown years earlier. They asked him to join.
Yeah, I'll think about it. I'll think about it. Let me get back to you. At that second, I already knew that I was going to say, yes, yes, tour. Yes, I want to do it. I want to do it. Because, I mean, playing Avalon, we didn't go on tour. We played one gig per year or something like that.
John Norum had a chance encounter with Håkan Haugland in a Stockholm music shop.
Two light bulbs just kind of flipped. It's like, jing. It's like, wow, that guy. I remember that guy. He was really good. So I asked him if he wanted to come for an audition.
I was just like, yeah, sure, absolutely. I'm in. Yeah. Give it to me.
Yes!
Since you
Thank you so much, thank you. Thank you, Sharon. It's gonna be one of those nights that I'm feeling, it feels good. It's gonna be hot. It's gonna be loud. You guys look good. Yeah, look at that. Beautiful place. Just 3 weeks ago when we were picking songs and looking at lyrics and putting this show together, it was kind of emotional because it's been 40 years with these guys and it's just been an amazing ride and an amazing journey. And I was looking at the lyrics and I saw lyrics that was referencing tragic events in the world, dramatic events in the world. I saw lyrics that described relationship with my loved ones, my friends, and also tragic stories about people around the crew and the band. Everything is sort of in the lyrics, and it was so emotional. So this show was very special. There was also references to our relationship with you, with our audience. And it's been so fantastic. There are lyric lines about how we feel together when we hear the music flowing through us and we just get together as one and the world outside just stays outside and this is a special moment and we feel the same way that you do, you know? So we would like to thank you all for coming out. This is a special tour for us. It's very emotional. It's kind of fun as well. We're doing songs we haven't done in a long time. You'll see. But if we don't play your particular favorite song, it's not my fault, it's those guys. Anyway, this is our new favorite here on stage. Here's a new song for you. Hold your head up.
Oh,
said he's a madman, that he don't understand. Don't think he knows for sure. Act like a man. All those years he has suffered, my friend. All those years of pain. I don't think he knows for sure if those years were in vain. He said to me, and he's fighting for his life. He's trying to understand. He's a dream. Lonely man. Thank you so much, thank you.
What the fuck's going on here? Feels like we're in the middle of some sort of cocktail party, you know? Meine Damen und Herren, herzlich willkommen heute Abend zu unserer Cocktail Party. But we're not only here for the cocktail party, right? We're here for that one too. The time capsule. And you know, it's a weird thing, isn't it? Time. It used to go faster every year. When you're a little kid, you know, 1 year, it's like an eternity. But now, 1 year is like, what happened? What was that? Can I have it again? No. So, the weird thing about time is that memories stick with you. And I don't know if it's easier to remember when time goes faster, I have no clue, but I still have a few memories from the 40 years we've been together. And those 40 years, man, how could we stay together that long? Because of you guys. And speaking about memories, I have a hard time remembering things generally, but I do remember the first song that Joe and I wrote together, and that goes something like this.
Woo! I see. I'm the
structure. There is still some love around here. Thank you. So kind of you to give us flowers tonight. You're so kind, you're so kind, you're so kind. Oh, thank you.
Thank you.
You don't know how it feels to sit next to a legend, John Norum on the guitar. Oh my gosh.
Thank you, sir.
And as you know, he's a great singer too. We met when we were 13 or something. So we're pretty fucking tired of each other now.
Yeah. That's for damn sure. Joke.
We used to sit on this little rock playing acoustic guitar together and dreaming about the band and everything. But one of the songs we played...
This is one of the songs that we used to jam. We were... This...
This
maybe,
one?
Maybe like the... I don't know.
Today, for here,
Sure. What a night. I'm getting into one of those zones. Beautiful.
See if you recognize this one. Take it back to 1982, one of the first songs we played together, and we recorded it for our album 1983.
we think it's kind of fun.
There is no time to pay my sin. Everywhere blows a fire wind. I'm all alone, trying to survive.
Thank you.
can't hear you. Fucking Berlin Friday night. I need a scream. Come on. Yeah, that's more like it. Well, I know you had a couple of beers and so it shouldn't be too hard for you to just let loose and get fucking crazy. Well, you know, 40 years. It's a pretty long time, right? I guess there's a lot of people down here that isn't even 40 years old. Oh, I can see you. I can see you. Oh, oh, oh. I can tell you, being plus 40 is a burden. But you know what? Because of you guys, because of your love, affection, and your support, and for you coming to see us every night, you know, that helps. It helps an old man to feel young at heart. That's right. Listen, the guys here in the band, they're always nagging on me about the drum solo. You know, Johnny needs to go to the toilet, and Joey needs to, I don't know, do something. So, what do you think about drum solos? Do you like drum solos? Come on. Drum solos are boring! Yeah! It's boring! So, okay. Hey, take it easy. Take it easy, man. Listen, I got a question for you. Are you ready for something completely different? I said, are you ready for something completely different? Well, here it comes.
Sit on my face and tell me that you love me. I sit on your face and tell you I love you too.
And that was something completely different.
We'll be right back.
on dreaming each and every night. We're gonna make it. That's what we'll do. Right to the end. We're gonna walk on, walk on through. Keep on walking, run, run, never fall. Call up my name, I'll be there. Parents, you're ready, easy to take. Get out of here!